May I request Honourable Mr. Justice A. Hariprasad deliver the welcome.
Good morning. Honourable the Chief Justice, Mr. Sri.S.Manikumar, my esteemed brother Mr. Shafiq, brothers Mr. Justice Sunil Thomas, Justice Satish Nainan, Justice Arun, my brother Justice Dias, my brother Justice Babu, learned additional director Srimadi Sutha, Sri Rajesh deputy director, Sri Ganesh assistant director, dear participants, once again good morning to all of you. So I'm happy for being a part of this training program, which is unique in its nature or first time in the history of the Kerala Judicial Academy. Because when extraordinary situations happen, probably you have to resort to extraordinary remedies. Basically, it's my view that unless you have eye contact with the trainees, it may be difficult to convey things to the mind of the recipients, and also it may be difficult to understand whether they are receiving it properly. But we have no other option but to go for such training programs in the wake of this pandemic outbreak. The Socratic method is also, because one person speaking, others listening, probably that also may not be very good, because interactive sessions are always useful to understand how much of the information from the speaker goes into the head of the recipient. Anyway, we have our own limitations. Academy has to do something for this, for the training programs you have to start off. So I'm happy to be part of this new venture, and I just slip on to my assigned duty. I need not express any, I need not what you call, address my Honourable Chief Justice, because he is the patron of the Academy and he is the patriarch of this institution, and he has been very cooperative in all the activities of the Academy right from the beginning. With immense pleasure, I invite Honourable Chief Justice to this new edition of the training program to inaugurate. I request him to inaugurate the program. Now, Mr. Justice Shafiq has taken over as the president of the Academy. This is his first venture or training program. I wholeheartedly welcome him to this program. My esteemed brothers Sunil, Justice Satish and Justice Arun are very much part of the Academy. For the sake of formality, I invite them also to the program. My esteemed brother Babu, he has taken over as the Director of Academics, and this is his first venture. Mr. Babu is, my brother Babu knows what is the advantage of speaking one-to-one. You are speaking to virtual images, but then we have to go for this. Justice Dias, I'm extremely happy that you have agreed to share your wisdom on this family court matters with the trainees, and I strongly believe that it will be very beneficial for the trainees. Srimadi Sudha, Sri Rajesh, Ganesh, who have worked relentlessly for this program, also deserves kudos. I request the trainees to utilize this opportunity to the maximum. Please have interaction. Use this opportunity. I welcome each one of you to this program. I don't want to waste time on this. Please, everyone is welcome. I extend a welcome to everyone with wholeheartedness. Right. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. May I now welcome the President, Honorable Mr. Justice A.M. Shafiq, to deliver the President's address.
Good morning to you all. Our Chief Justice, Sri Manikumar. Esteemed brother Sri Hariprasad, other members of the Board of Governors, Justice Sunil Thomas, Justice Satish Naina, Justice Vijay Arun, the Justice G.S. Dias, who has agreed to conduct classes today, other sister and brother judges who are participating in this conference, Justice Babu, who is the Director of Academics, Additional Director Srimadi Sudha, judicial officers who are participating in this program, Good morning to you all once again. This is a new program which we have developed since we are faced with a pandemic. Therefore, it is necessary that we should continue the process of training that the Judicial Academy had been doing for quite a long time. I indeed accept the, or rather concur with the apprehension expressed by Justice Hariprasad that an eye-to-eye meeting is actually required. But the fact remains that the situation is changing. We have to cope up with new situation, and we have now facilities to interact through video conferencing methods, and therefore we have to utilize all such methods to ensure that the process or the training continues. We cannot keep quiet. We have to live with any situation that may arise in future, or we should be equipped with such technology that is required from time to time. We may encounter this after a few discussions through video conferencing. I am sure that all of us will be able to ensure that our process, the training programs will continue like before. Even without the presence of the participants across the table, still, you know, in the High Court, we some of our judges were actively conducting or rather hearing cases through video conferencing method, through the same app. And Mr. C.S. Dias, Justice C.S. Dias is also one among those young technology inventors who can really give necessary inputs to this sort of programs. So therefore, this is the first program Academy is conducting for judicial officers through virtual mode, and I thank all the member participants and the persons who are behind this program to ensure that this would be a success. And probably until the pandemic is over and we are permitted to have training programs like before, we should continue this program. That apart, even if some we want to even after this, the technology is improving and we may have better facilities which could be achieved through the technology that is coming up or rather presently available. So we should try to ensure that the technological advancements are also included in achieving the target which we have set for ourselves. I think we need not waste much time on all this, but still, I once again thank all of you who are participants in this to have come forward, and let us wish that this program is a great success. I therefore invite our Chief Justice to render the inaugural address.
Thank you, sir. Now we request the Honourable Chief Justice to inaugurate the program and deliver the inaugural speech.
Honourable Brother Justice Shafiq, President, Board of Governors, Kerala State Judicial Academy, my esteemed brother judges, members of the Board, Kerala State Judicial Academy, Honourable Justice Babu, Director of Academics, Kerala Judicial Academy, Honourable Justice Charlie, Judge, High Court of Kerala, Dr. John C. senior consultant psychiatrist, Medical Trust Hospital, Ernakulam, director and additional directors of Kerala Judicial Academy, family court judges. Good morning to all. Due to COVID-19 pandemic, the world is going through difficult times, and nobody can predict when normalcy would be restored. We need to change and adapt ourselves to the changing and testing times. Necessity to conduct virtual training programs on a regular basis is the need of the hour. During the lockdown period, domestic violence and family disputes have increased. Institution of family has to preserve and conserve. Children, the future of our nation, require care and protection. They have to be nurtured with parental care and affection. Rightly, the Academy has chosen the topics for this training session: saving of marriages in crisis and adoption and guardianship procedure. As a first initiative towards virtual training programs, today Kerala Judicial Academy has organized skill development training for family court judges on compassionate approach to resolution of family disputes and adoption through video conferencing. On this occasion, I congratulate Brother Justice Shafiq and other honorable judges, members of the Board of Governors of Kerala Judicial Academy, for conducting this program for the judges of the family courts in the state. I thank Honorable Justice Dias, other resource persons, for the participation in this program. I sincerely hope that this training program, aimed at to sensitize the judges of the family courts, will be fruitful and beneficial in discharging the judicial functions. I'm extremely thankful to all those persons involved, the director, the additional director, the director academics, and staff who have devised this program so as to enable our honorable judges to participate in this virtual training program. I'm extremely thankful to the board of directors who have given me this opportunity to inaugurate this program, virtual training program of the Kerala Judicial Academy. Accordingly, I inaugurate. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. We don't have a formal vote of thanks because the program continues with the two sessions we have, two morning sessions by Honorable Mr. Justice C.S. Dias. Honorable Mr. Justice C.S. Dias is first time in this academy, and therefore I request the Regional Director C.S. Sudha to introduce Honorable Mr. C.S. Dias to the participants.
Warm good morning to one and all. It's my honor and privilege to formally introduce His Lordship, Honorable Mr. Justice C.S. Dias. Lordship graduated from the Government Law College, Thiruvananthapuram, in the year 1992. Thereafter started practicing in the High Court of Kerala, and also before the other courts in Ernakulam. My Lord was counsel for High Court of Kerala for the period from 2016 to 2019, has held several other positions like the retainer standing counsel for the Ministry of Railways in the High Court from 2010 to 2019, central government counsel from 2012 to 2015, standing counsel for the Indian Oil Corporation from 2006 to 2019, member of the National Advisory Committee, the Ministry of Women and Child Development, counsel and consultant for several non-governmental organizations, institutions, congregations, and corporate entities. My Lord has specialized in civil, constitutional, family and arbitration laws. Lordship was sworn in as additional judge of the High Court on 18/11/2019. This is Lordship's first visit to the Academy. I warmly welcome my Lord to the Academy, and I request His Lordship to take over the session. Thank you.